In the Antarctic Ocean, companies are fishing for krill to use it as feed for salmon.
In this clip, we will shortly go over the effect krill fishing has on the ecosystem, we will talk about the current salmon feed, and finish whether or not we can replace krill by insects. Krill is the only animal in this region that consumes plankton, a plant which performs photosynthesis, taking up CO2 and water to convert this into nutrients and oxygen for other animals. Because of this photosynthesis, there will be a reduction of CO2 in the air. Many animals in this Antarctic ecosystem consume krill, such as penguins, seals, and whales. Since the 1970s, the krill population has decreased by 80%, and it is estimated to decrease even more due to its high demand in feed for fish. This decrease will especially affect the penguin population and is expected to shrink by 1/3. This decrease in krill is caused by two factors, namely global warming and fishing. In total, there is 379 million tons of krill available in all oceans worldwide. It is used as feed for many animals because of its favorable composition. Krill has a protein content of almost 60% and a fat content of almost 20%, of which a large part consists of omega-3. Lastly, krill is favorable to be used in salmon feed because it contains coloring agents which makes the salmon pink. After fishing of the krill, it is combined with soy, grain corn, and peas to form the salmon feed. As krill clearly isn't a sustainable feed source, we need to look for other solutions. As of 2017, the legislation changed, which made it possible to use insects as a protein source for fish feed. There are two insects being investigated for use in feed, namely the black soldier fly and the housefly. The common housefly is not yet being used to feed fish, as opposed to the black soldier fly, which is already being used to feed salmon. The protein content of the common housefly is more similar to that of krill and would then be a better option. However, the fat content of the black soldier fly is more favorable. Both insects lack the colorant that is present in krill, for which another solution needs to be found. We are off to a good start with these changes in legislation, but we still need to overcome some hurdles. Insects have a good protein content, but their fat content, and especially their omega-3 content, will be insufficient in replacing krill. Furthermore, using insects as feed is still too expensive. Lastly, it is forbidden to use insects that have been reared on waste, which would be the most sustainable solution. If these hurdles are overcome, insects as feed will take off. Although replacing krill by insects will not be easy, it will save the ecosystem and make the penguins and seals happy again.